Welcome to this episode of the Camtasia 9 Survival Guide, where I'll show you some quick tips for getting your Camtasia 8 library into Camtasia 9. And we're starting right now. Hi, Lon Naylor here, and if you're new to this channel, be sure to click the subscribe button and the bell icon thingy to stay up to date with the latest greatest Camtasia tips and tricks. Here's the issue we're going to look at today. When you first install and open Camtasia 9, you'll immediately notice some big changes in your library. In fact, it's completely new. While that in and of itself is kind of awesome, right? What if you've been using the library in Camtasia 8 for the last 4 years as intended? Adding additional assets and custom reusable components and organizing them into folders and really coming to rely on them being here, like I have. Well, after installing Camtasia 9, you'll notice that those are nowhere to be found. None of them. So here are my top tips for effectively rebuilding your Camtasia 9 library with all your stuff from Camtasia 8. Note that this is a manual process and we have several ways to go about doing this. But basically, they all adhere to the concept of getting library assets out of Camtasia 8 and into Camtasia 9. I have a couple options for you on how to do that. Check them all out and decide which one is best for you. Here they are. Option 1. You can just export the whole shebang in one fell swoop by opening your Camtasia 8 library, click on any item, then press Ctrl+A to select everything. You can then right-click and choose Export Library, or go to File, Library, Export Library. The export process will then ask for a location and a file name. I recommend creating a special folder just for saving your Camtasia 8 library files. This will make it easy to find later when we bring them into Camtasia 9. And I also recommend giving this a descriptive name. This creates what's called a library zip file, or libzip for short. And it's pretty much what it sounds like, a compressed zip file with all the stuff that you selected when you exported it from your library. To bring this into your Camtasia 9 library, you can just double-click the libzip file in your Windows Explorer, which will automatically bring the contents of the zip file into your library. It will recognize that this file comes from a previous version, and this dialog box will appear. And it is possible that some assets can't be imported. The only ones I've actually had a problem with are MOV video files that have alpha channel transparency, which isn't supported in Camtasia 9.
Oh!
Yeah, I'll talk a lot more about this in a future episode. And you can also import by going to File, Library, Import Zipped Library. Click the folder icon and navigate to where you saved your Camtasia 8 library file and open it that way. Option 2 is that instead of exporting the entire library, you can pick and choose what you want to save. This is what I've done for my rather massive Camtasia 8 library as almost a housekeeping measure, sort of a spring cleaning, if you will. For example, some of the original themes that installed automatically in Camtasia 8, I don't really like and I never use. Some I do like and I use them a lot. Like this Behind the Cloud theme. I use this animated title video clip a lot, and often the static title, and just maybe a couple of the other callouts in the theme. So I can cherry pick the things I like by holding down the Control key and selecting them individually, and then again right click and choose Export Library. The box to create a new zip file comes up. Click the folder to navigate to the directory where I'm saving my Camtasia 8 library files. And again, I highly recommend you give this a descriptive name so you'll know what it is when it comes time to import it, and follow the process we covered for actually importing them. You can also use your Control key to select things like multiple folders at a time. And when you import them, the folder structures and all the assets inside of them will remain intact. or export just individual items. Here I have things I've saved to the library but haven't put into folders, for example. And one little trick I do in this case is to click on the asset name as if I'm going to rename it and copy the name. Right-click to export, and then just paste the name when I save it. So there you have it. The basics of rebuilding your Camtasia 8 library into Camtasia 9. Hey, thanks for watching. I hope you found this tip useful. To keep up to date with all the episodes in the Camtasia 9 Survival Guide, be sure to sign up for the special newsletter so I can send you new tips, tricks, tutorials, and resources to help make your transition to Camtasia 9 as smooth as possible. Just click the link to sign up, leave your questions and comments, and I'll chat with you soon.